In 1918, an outbreak of influenza resulted in one of the worst pandemics in world history. What caused this pandemic to occur? How widespread was the suffering? No one is sure where the Spanish flu originated. Some believe the pandemic began in Fort Riley, Kansas. Others pinpoint China or East Asia. Still others have speculated that the source of the flu was Austria or France. Regardless of its origin, in late 1917, doctors in Europe began reporting an outbreak of a disease with a high mortality rate. They eventually identified it as a strain of influenza known as H1N1, now known as the swine flu. This particular strain initially spread amongst soldiers in World War I. The overcrowded conditions of military encampments, trenches, and military hospitals created the perfect environment for spreading an airborne illness. The disease spread quickly because when an infected individual coughs or sneezes, more than 500,000 virus particles can be spread to those in close proximity. This was made worse by the conditions of World War I. Many soldiers were malnourished and suffering from the stress of combat. This led to millions of men with weakened immune systems and left them highly susceptible to viral infection. The flu spread from country to country at a rapid rate. Again, the wartime conditions likely enhanced its global dissemination. Soldiers were leaving the battlefields and returning home, or traveling to foreign shores as they were deployed. As they moved, the flu traveled with them. Additionally, the ease of travel contributed to how quickly the flu spread. Ships, trains, and automobiles moved faster than ever before, which meant the flu was on the move as well. No part of the world was untouched by the flu. Ireland, Great Britain, India, Iran, Japan, Samoa, and New Zealand all experienced outbreaks. The flu was first reported in the United States in Kansas during the spring of 1918. It spread rapidly, and by mid-March had reached Queens, New York. The global nature of the outbreak is why the event is referred to as a pandemic. A pandemic is defined as the outbreak of a disease that is prevalent throughout the entire world. The international press focused on the disease as it made its way out of France and into the Iberian Peninsula. The country affected the most at that time was Spain. Therefore, many in the media began referring to it as the Spanish flu, which is the name it is still known by to this day. The virus caused hemorrhaging in the nose, stomach, intestines, and lungs. Hemorrhaging in the lungs caused the sufferer to drown from the buildup of fluids. Patients could also bleed from the ears or mouths. These symptoms, along with other complications, caused the Spanish flu to be an extremely deadly form of the flu. Death rates for the flu are generally about 0.1% of those infected. However, with the Spanish flu, somewhere between 10 to 20% of those infected died, either due to the flu itself or from complications that arose from their infection. Strangely enough, young adults, ages 20 to 40, were infected and died at the highest rate. This is abnormal compared to most outbreaks of the flu, where infants and the elderly suffer the most. Death tolls were high in numerous countries. Over 400,000 died in France, while about 250,000 died in Great Britain. More than 900,000 lost their lives in Iran, and a staggering 17 million may have died in India. In the United States, approximately 28% of the population contracted the illness, with somewhere between 500,000 to 675,000 succumbing to death. In many cases, deaths were the result of bacterial pneumonia, a secondary infection associated with the flu. The Spanish flu impacted the economy as well as other aspects of day-to-day life. Many stores closed, while others did not allow customers to enter. Instead, visitors were asked to leave their orders on the doorstep outside. Agriculture was also affected because the flu, coupled with the war, caused a severe shortage in the number of farmhands to work fields and harvest crops. Many people were afraid to leave their homes altogether. When they did, some resorted to wearing handkerchiefs or even gas masks over their faces. Doctors and nurses had difficulty meeting the demands for their services. Many in both professions were overseas assisting with the war effort. As a result, third and fourth year nursing students were released from school to work in hospitals. Sadly, gravediggers and those who built coffins also had difficulty meeting the demand. In some cases, bodies were left outside for days at a time. In others, bodies were buried without coffins or in mass graves. While many today think of the Spanish flu pandemic as one event, there were actually three separate outbreaks of the virus. The first was in March of 1918. A second deadly wave occurred in the fall of 1918. October of 1918 was one of the worst months in terms of mortality rates, with 200,000 deaths recorded in the United States alone. The third and final wave occurred during the winter of 1919. In the months and years that followed, the Spanish flu pandemic was largely forgotten. World War I had raged for 4 years and had impacted virtually everyone's life. As a result, the war largely overshadowed the outbreak of the flu, which lasted for such a brief time. In many countries, focus was placed on the millions who had died in combat rather than those who had perished from the pandemic. However, the Spanish flu infected 500 million people and resulted in the deaths of 50 to 100 million worldwide. This would mean it took the lives of 3 to 5% of the world's population. This would also mean that the Spanish flu claimed more lives in less than a year than the Black Plague did in 100 years. The Spanish flu is remembered today as one of the deadliest natural disasters in the history of humanity.